Hey, this is the Daily Overpass. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now today, let's talk about communication problems and how you throw the ball. All right, I realize that I talk a lot about my mistakes and my failures more than I talk about the things that I do right or that Overpass does right. And one of the main reasons for that is because if I talk about all the things we do successfully, that's really boring. We don't learn anything from it. There's nothing to glean from that. It would be a video that said, hey, we released a client project today. Everybody performed well. We delivered on time. The client's really happy. That's it for today. I'll talk to you tomorrow. So it's more interesting to talk about when we mess things up, and you always have little issues here and there that creep up. So the reason I'm saying that, because I don't want you guys to think I'm incompetent or anything, because that's all I ever talk about. The reality is there's a lot of things that go right and a few things that we learn from along the way. So having said that, we had a bit of an issue this morning, right? So we have one of the many client projects we have going on. I was going through testing something and found that the work had not been done. And having talked to the developer, it turns out he was working on the wrong thing. And I guess I kind of got a little bit upset. I didn't shout or anything like that. I was just like, you better fix this right away. You better do this, you know, you better do this. And I was just, and then I just, you know, my mind starts boiling over, so I just had to go for a drive. I went for a drive, and it was one of those kind of drives where I'm just driving and muttering, how could I get this wrong? How could you be working on the wrong thing? I don't understand it, blah, 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 right? And, you know, I should have done the video out on the road, but I didn't even bring the camera with me. I just would, like, grabbed my coat and went. And so as I was driving and as I started to calm down, I started to think about some of the mistakes I've made in the past as a junior developer, right? And there's one case in particular that I want to talk about today. So, like, my first IT job was at an investment bank, and I didn't really have a lot of experience, so they gave me Microsoft Access work to do. So I was doing I got really good at Microsoft Access, so I was doing a lot of management reports. So I would do these reports for, like, paper-based reports that were, like, really sensitive information, like people's salaries and their appraisal scores and their bonuses, and I would deliver these to different meetings so that the senior managers could make all these important decisions. And everybody was really happy with my work because I worked very long hours. You know, I was very meticulous with these reports. But so eventually, one of the more senior people came to me and said, "All right, we have this very, like, the final meeting where we decide on all the top." The management committee is going to get together and they're going to decide on the bonuses for the top people. So I need you to produce the reports for those. And I said, good, I already have the query for that. It'd be the same. We just need to change the criteria. Everything was fine. He says, okay, great. Just, you know, it's on this day or whatever, right? And the day before the meeting, so this was a big deal. So I'm going to make sure I did a really good job. So I printed them off a few days before the meeting just to make sure that everything was right. Everything was checked over. And the day before the meeting, I get copied in on an email that he sent to somebody else saying that, you know, these five people are going to be attending the meeting too, right? And I thought, I wasn't sure why I was copied in, but I thought, okay, I just didn't do anything with it. I didn't follow up to say, is there any reason why I'm copied in on this email? It's not, you know, not addressing me directly. So the next morning, about an hour before this big meeting, he comes over and says, you saw that email yesterday, right? So he makes sure those five people are not on the reports, their sensitive information is not on the reports. And I thought, oh, is that what I was supposed to do? Okay, yeah, I'll do that right away. I'll take them off the reports. I'll reprint the reports. So I took all the reports that I had and I mulched them or put them in this big secure thing that they get mulched, and I started running the query again. Now, this was a Microsoft Access query, and it was really slow to run because it had lots of different ODBC sources, like linked tables, which were coming through. If you know about this kind of thing, it's kind of, so it would take like 10 minutes to run. Probably wasn't the best design query either because I was still just very new at it. So I went through and I started trying to remove these people from it, and I would run the query, and it would be like, and wait the 10 minutes, and I see they're still in there, and then I would do it again, they're still in there, and it was getting, you know, the meeting's going to start in 10 minutes, it's going to start in 5 minutes. So eventually my direct manager comes over and goes, everybody's asking where these reports are, what's going on? And I said, you know, I can't get these people off this report. And he starts yelling at me. We start shouting, what do you mean you can't get them off the report? Why can't you get them off the report? I don't know. They're just not disappearing. And it was just like really heated and frantic. And in the end, he said, we printed off what we had. All right, and he got like five other people, and we actually went through with a black magic marker and crossed off the names of those five people page by page. You know, all there was like a 60-page report going, are they on that page? Are they on that page? On that page? Right? It was not very efficient at all. These big black lines on these really nice looking reports. Right? And it was like, you know, the meeting's been going for 10 minutes, been going for, it just time kept going by. And finally, I got all the reports, everybody handed it to me. I ran down to the floor where this big meeting was going. And we're talking Canary Wharf. So it was like huge marble and, you know, giant, like the big desk, and all the people in this meeting were making millions each year, right? So I'm walking with these big reports, this big stack of reports, and I see the main director, I see his assistant standing outside the office. So I go, here, can you take these in for me, please? And she says, no way I'm taking those in. Those things are 45 minutes late. It's only an hour long meeting. All right, so I went to the door and I opened it, and I could remember the look everybody gave me. They were so annoyed with the fact that they were sitting around waiting for these reports to be delivered. And I just went, and I didn't make eye contact with anybody, and I just dropped them off in front of everybody. And the first thing they noticed was all the black lines across it. And I said, I'm sorry, we couldn't remove some of those people. And so I just delivered it really quickly. Right? And the senior manager who had given me the task, he was in the meeting and he looked very upset. And I was like, I just didn't know what to say. So I just quickly delivered them and then I left. Right? After the meeting, 15 minutes later, I went to the senior manager's desk and I apologized. I know you told me how important these were. I'm sorry I messed up. He says, you know, one of those names was still in the report. It was very embarrassing for them that we all saw how much money they made and everything. And I said, I'm really, we missed one? I'm so sorry. I really messed this up and everything like that. And I honestly thought he was going to fire me. At that moment, I thought that was it. He was going to let me go, right? Because I just, you know, it was such an important meeting, right? So he told me, so I said, I'm really sorry. And he said, you know, sit down. So I was in his office and he said, sit down. So I sat down and I was terrified. I thought, this is it. I've only been here 3 months. He's gonna fire me. And he said, do you know why jugglers mess up? You know, I said, and I wasn't quite sure what he meant. He goes, do you know why when jugglers are juggling, do you know why they fail sometimes and drop the balls? And I said, no. He says, most people think it's because they fail to catch the ball, but most of the time it's because they throw it wrong, right? And he said, the point I'm trying to make is, yes, you made a mistake, but it was my responsibility to make sure you understood how everything worked when I gave it to you. I threw the ball incorrectly, so it's not all on you, it's on me too, right? And I didn't lose my job. I remember asking, so you're not going to fire me? And he said, why would I fire you? Look how much it's costing me to train you, right? So I felt a bit bad about that too, right? Because it was, I know it was just a meeting, but these people, their time was very, very valuable and they sat there waiting, right? So I thought about that this morning as I was driving, after speaking with the, you know, you better did this, and I'm just, and I thought, did I throw the ball correctly, right? Is this all on the developer? Could I have been more clear? Could I have done something differently that this would have worked out better, right? I thought it was very clear. It works most of the other time, but this time a mistake happened. And I thought, could I have been more clear? Yes. Did he mess up because he was incompetent? No, his code is great. Did he mess up because he's lazy? No, he did work on something, right? Is there any way that we could fix this, right? Yes, right? So what we had here was a communication problem, and the communication problem is on me too, right? It's not his mistake, it's our mistake. The reality is the client wants the best app they can get. I want the client to have the best app they can get, and the developer wants to create the best app that they can. So we have all the right ingredients, but we messed up. So we have a couple of days delay. I need to make a difficult phone call to the client, but you know, that's on me. And we just need to look at our processes going forward, saying in these kind of situations, how can we be more clear going forward? And you know, these things happen and this is what we learned from. And you know, it's not just the developer's responsibility to understand, it is the manager's responsibility to be clear, and that's it. So let me know what you guys think. I'm gonna talk about, you know what, I'm gonna make a point to talk about some of the things that we do right around here too, because I don't want you guys to think we're always messing up. And that is it for today. I'll talk to you guys again tomorrow.